So we built a submarine. The submarine includes a couple motors. They're both reversible DC motors. We have a water pump for our ballast tank, and it sucks in water and then it releases it. And then we also have one for the rear, and that controls the propeller, so it can propel it forward or it can propel it backwards.
We included two servo motors for steering too. This servo motor attaches to this front stabilizer when it's in the tube, and it controls it going up and down. The back one controls this back rudder that turns it left and right, and they're both sealed.
And this is our controller. It basically consists of a 5-position switch and a joystick, which is essentially 2 potentiometers, and it has an LCD screen and an on-off switch. The first thing you do is hit the center button, press down to activate everything. Right now, it's showing us where we are. It's on full stop and surface. So if you hit up, it would turn the motor on and spin it forward. Going back down would go to full stop again, and down again is reverse. And if you go to the right and down, it activates the submerge mode, and it alarms a buzzer telling you that you're submerging. And then once you're in that mode, if you hit right, you start to sink and it pulls in water into the ballast system, and it does that while the button is held down to the right. And then going to the left releases the water from the ballast system. To turn off that system and come to the surface, you go to the left and click down. And we have an accelerometer that measures the tilt, and when you tilt it one way, it'll automatically adjust the stabilizers to make you stay level.
On the sub, we have a pink 88, and then we also have the accelerometer, as mentioned, and 2 H-bridges, which run both of our DC motors. And then we also have a receiver. Inside of the controller, we have a PIC 917, a 16F917, a 40-pin PIC, running our LCD screen. Our buzzer has 2 inputs from the joystick, 5 inputs from the 5-input switch, the transmitter, and a buzzer.
There's also a bladder down here that when we suck in water, it holds the water to make it sink, and then when we pump it back out, it'll go back up. And the rest here is just added weight that we added for the buoyancy, because it has to be about 20 pounds to actually
be neutrally buoyant in the water.
Yeah.